Okay, welcome back everyone to another episode of CK2, where as you guys know, we are going to be doing the slow but steady race to assassinate all his children. Because as you guys know, he has agnatic Gaveltkind, which basically means that he will be, every single child will be inherited until all of them are dead. And since he doesn't, technically agnatic means, wait, is it cognatic or agnatic? I'm going to have to look this up. Because I thought agnatic meant only women inherit, but maybe they changed that. Technology laws, there it is. Absolute cognatic. What does that give me? County, holder, negative opinion. Elective Gaveltkind, that'd be kind of interesting to see how that works out. But, nah. I can't really do much. Oh. It must be the other way around. Shoot. Well then, that basically means that there is absolutely no possibility, agnatic, cognatic, Gaveltkind. Okay, I guess it's cognatic that's the one that's, yeah, it must be. So, agnatic is the one that's basically, it's all males, cognatic is the one that's all females. Okay, got it. But, that still opens up a lot of doors for us. Like, I'm not fretting over this. Like, seriously, we married, like, a princess of his land, so eventually, I could just easily, well, actually, even if I assassinate them, they're still gonna come back. I'm gonna have to think about this, but I gained a lot of prestige for arranging our alliance, and now he has two people. I really want to kill him. I really have to make sure she does not have a child. Have we figured out a plot yet? I mean, do I need to bribe people? Let's see. Does anyone want to... Let's get the plot power. Ooh, yeah, you. Hey, I'm going to send you some money, and you're going to come to my plot, and then we're going to kill his wife so that, you know, he does not have any children. Because I know I could just, like, leave it alive and then just wait, but she's 21. Yeah, no, let him plot. Yeah, you sleep with my wife, I'm going to let you rot in jail forever and ever and ever. In fact, I will make sure I forget about you eventually. You will never, like, this guy? Oh, yay, my wife is pregnant! Please be a daughter. Daughters would help me out so much right now. Okay, and let's see. Where do I go? Let's see, can I do anything right now? No. I could buy indulgence. That'd be really cool. But I have a spy master on the side. William is set free? Absolutely not. Oh. Diplomacy, explain why I can't. With my bishop. Yes, let's do that. Because I severely don't want this guy out of prison. Why? Because he honestly made me very mad. Okay. And there it is, prisoners. Yeah, like, this guy, I'm gonna make sure I forget about him, and hopefully in, like, 60 years, he'll still be in prison, and we could just, like, visit him and be like, hey, how you, oh, he's a greedy guy, too, so I feel no sympathy for you, and he's slothful, and he's a hedonist, and he's an elusive shadow. Yeah, you, sorry, sir, you are going to make sure you stay in prison forever. I will literally never let you out, and, yeah. That's just the end of that. So, on to other things, such as threats in our internal realm, known plots, not very much. Killing this guy's wife is apparently taking longer than I ever thought it would be possible. Probably because I'm cheap and I really don't want to spend that much on killing her. You want medium? Okay, no. That's the one I have to say no to, because if you get to medium crown authority, then we have issues. Like, I can't let you do medium, because then I literally cannot expand without killing lots and lots of people. And I preferably don't want to do that. So, also, these guys love me, by the way. Just saying. Okay. You know what, Chancellor? You're better spent just improving relationships with everyone. Go improve relationships with the guy in Brunswick, so that eventually... Another son! Oh, shoot. Let's name him... You know, son. You know, he'll be Augusta son, Augustusson. Augustusson. Yes, he's Augustusson. Because he's the one that's the genius sickly guy. Might not survive infancy. Oh, he's sickly. He might not survive infancy. Okay. You know, on one hand, it's really bad that he's sickly. And I really feel for him. And if he dies, that'd be really good for us so that we don't get Gavelkind succession. Even though we only have one province, I still don't want to deal with that. But on the other hand, he is a genius. And I think it might come to a point where I might have to assassinate my firstborn. Oh gosh, this is terrible. I'm already making... Oh man. Hey, I may have to kill you, Rudolph Shredder James. This is terrible! This kind elderly man of humble and like, you know, humble beginnings may have to kill his own son. Because this guy's already better than his brother. Like, in every way. And he's only 0 years old. Like, the potential for this guy is way more. Okay, he is now my new chancellor. Okay, let me look at you. You are better. Yes, he is my new chancellor. Yes, sorry. That guy is, like, infinitely times better. You're now gonna go improve relationships. And as created the Duchy of Tyrol. That's good. You moved your primary title back to Baden. That's cool. I have a good chance of inheriting the throne at some point if I use that. But what we really need right now is a daughter. So, because, or unless this guy also produces a son. And for some reason, no one wants this woman dead. Maybe I should add more people to the plot. Yeah, apparently he found out and some people left the plot. Hey, you. Join plot. Yeah. Right. Let's go make this a little bit bigger, because I want her to die a little bit quicker. Okay, hey, you. Join plot. There we go. Okay. And resign from the council. No, I like being on the council. If I'm on the council, I make sure that this guy is treated very fairly. Ugh. Okay. And now plot power 196. Hey, you. Join the plot. And Corbio is no longer Stuart Augustine. Oh, wow. He was killed by an angry mob of peasants. That ain't good. Well, do we have anyone else to take his place? Yes, we have Wildrick. The bishop I think I really like. Well, collect taxes from my realm, because I need them. And let's see. You over here. Oh, Bruno is no longer spymaster. I think I literally have no one to replace him. Okay. And apparently, something happened here. So, anyways, that means I basically have to invite somebody to court. Because if I don't, I literally have no one. So let's invite that guy to court. I like the gold. Okay, and let's see how good is he. Because he's literally going to get the job no matter how good he is. Well, that isn't bad, actually. That's actually where I wanted him to be. So, yeah. Build a spy record. Approve a plan. Finally! Oh my goodness, it took you guys years to finally get this plan working. Let's hope we... Yay! My wife is pregnant again. Okay. Let's see if we do this. Come on, we have to kill her before she has children. Is she with child yet? No, she's not pregnant. Yes! Yes, did he find out? Success! The snakes performed its duty. It slipped away into the night, contained a lethal sector. Oh, they don't know I did it. Yes. Okay, that is good. So, it is official. I just killed off, you know, his wife. And hopefully, with that, he will not remarry. Well, if he does remarry, he marries somebody really old. Oh, shoot, he already remarried. Wow. Wow, that was quick. And she's even worse. This guy really does not know how to choose wives. Well, if he has any children, I'll kill them. Let's just put it like that. If he has any children, I'll kill them. But for this, though, what I have to do is... I have to carefully wait for my daughter because there's, I guess, I'm not going to be able to get to the throne just yet. I don't think I'm going to be able to arrange a marriage with, like, this guy. with my daughter, but we could try it, but I don't think it'll work. But let's see, my child lacks a guardian. Well, guess what, dude? You're gonna be tutored by your good old-fashioned mother. Because your mother is awesome about a lot of things, and literally no trait that she will give you, except for this one, would be bad. Like, especially this one, like, I would have really bad issues if, like, my child somehow came out and had this. Like, what dark arts did you perform, honey? Like, what happened? Oh, wow, I just realized I married, like, I'm 53 and she's 24, wow. I feel kind of feel, like, old now. Like, the more, like, the beard, the age, and just, like, how old she is makes me feel so old. Has to feel, yes! Okay, yes, I had a daughter. Okay, and Emia, you will be the daughter of mine, and now we will see what we could do with you, because you have a lot of political options. We could marry you to this guy, who has two sons, who I'm guessing the first one is reserved, because that's just usually what happens. Oh shoot, but if I do this, I'd have to literally kill off every single one of my children. Shoot, I completely forgot about that! Okay, never mind, it seems like I completely forgot about a couple things. But let's see if I could just do it just for the heck of it. Can I arrange a betrothal between my daughter of Emia and one of your Ludwig? Wow, I could. Could I get matrilineal marriage? I know this is a stretch, but could I get matrilineal marriages, King? He would accept. What? Wait. Is this right? Is this Prince Wellmanheimer? Is this the child I'm thinking of? Go to diplomacy. Yes, he's the child of his father, and he'd be the next in line. Holy shoot. You know what? Yeah, let's do this. If I'm gonna marry you, I'm gonna arrange betrothal between you and my Emia. It's gonna be matrilineal marriage, and I gained so much. Like, it's not. Yes, totally doing this. Okay, go. So, basically, what I just did is I literally just made it so that if I wanted to, and I almost feel like I want to, I have to kill off the entire Carling family. He would inherit, but then he would be not a Carling. Like, the child, like, if they would continue, I could basically, what I'm saying, people, is I could basically get my line to be in power in the next couple years, which I think I'll start working on right now. Let's see, I got 77% plot power, and I'm not even really, like, not many people really, you know, dislike me. Let's see. I have to look at who's the most powerful plotter. Yeah, I could probably get this guy killed. But yeah, we should start the process right now, because it's going to apparently take us a little bit to get this guy killed. So let's start the process, and as I slowly figure out where everything is on the map, because I'm still new to this, 88.5. Let's see, get the most plot. This guy right here would be nice. Yeah, send an invitation. Let's go right here. Go right here. And let's see you right there. Get into the plot. And there we go. Over 101%, so it should eventually fire, which would be really nice. And let us see. We also could get the Baron. We also could get all these lesser characters that, you know, could potentially help us, but they're not as important as I would think they are. I mean, this, I could probably squeeze a lot out of this, but honestly, I think after, maybe, yay, my wife's pregnant again, yay! Hopefully we have another daughter, because that'd be really nice. Also, let's improve my stewardship, because if I can improve my stewardship, that'd be really awesome. Like, seriously, I have terrible stewardship. It's all because I have a terrible life. And let's see. If I patrol to the... I don't know how I... Oh, she... And she's even... How did... Never mind. Okay. Well, my first child is with her. You know, I actually could No, I couldn't make this work even if I tried. Wait. If I kill off his entire dynasty, since they're under agnatic, you know, succession, the child of this... This is going to be very weird family relations. Let's just say that. In the next couple of years, we're going to find very weird family relations. But back over here to this guy. Is he still... He has just been pumping out sons like crazy. Okay. And I was hoping by now he would have a daughter of some kind. Like, maybe one I could easily, like, you know, marry off so that maybe I could have, you know, stuff. And this guy's not... This guy's really terrible. Like, he's a zealous, ambitious, lustful, proud person. He's also very trusting with all those traits. Wow. We would not like each other. No, we love each other. What? We're both scholars, that's why. We love each other because we're scholars. Wow. People who read books stick together, man. It's like almost like a hood. We stick together, we stick with our kind. And another daughter, yes! Okay. So I'm gonna name this one Ambition. Because I have big fans of this. Ambition. Hopefully I spelled this right. Ambition. It might be Ambition, but you know that's still an awesome name nonetheless. So, anyways, let's see. Have you already married them off? Not yet. Okay. So what we can do is use this one for an alliance. Oh, and Augustine asks,
Daddy, where do children come from?
Daddy will tell you when you get older, which gives him diligent, deceitful, or cynical. You know, they are bees and flowers. Oh, that's not exactly good either. Or, be silent or I'll smack you, which then gets thoughtful, wrath, or craven. This is actually the only one that's actually semi-good. Hopefully he'll get good. Oh, well, cynical isn't terrible, it's just not exactly great. And I really can't think of it right now, but, yeah. I think I'm just gonna have to go with it, but anyways, if we were possibly to marry off, strong claim on the Duke of Saxony, you do, man. The East Frisian Revolt! Oh no! Is it over to Lower Crown Authority? Because I would totally be a part of that. I totally don't want our king to get more Crown Authority. That would be a terrible, terrible, terrible idea. Let's see. Do people want... Oh shoot, people left my plot. Oh shoot. Oh shoot, and I'm stressed. Shoot, that is not good. That is not good. Okay, let's see. Does people still want him dead? They do. Alright, let's invite you to the plot. Because apparently people left. Alright, and let's see. We have to make sure that how much plot power we have. I think we need to include like one more. Yeah, one more person should be able to do it. There we go. We have a 103% plot power. I don't think I'm going to be able to get much more than 100%, but we need to start killing off some of this guy's children. So that then if we can get this child to be inheriting, we basically have my dynasty take over, which I guess is going to be good. I can't wait to see that happen. That'd be kind of nice. You know, seeing the Shredder James banner over all underneath of East Frisia. Oh, but Gotland of East has revolted. It looks like they might actually win because we have a weakened realm right now. That is not good, Leash. That is not good. And then high taxes, revolts, yada yada yada. Well, they've been saying they'd get revolts for years, and my realm has been basically peaceful for years. And let's see, let's just improve relationships with everyone at home. And I apparently gained one stewardship because I read books. And people keep dropping the plot, man. People keep dropping the plot. Oh, you're back. Hey, totally join. You should join, man. We totally need you. Dude, if you join the plot, we totally got enough. And wait for him to join. There we go. And obviously, I think he keeps discovering all the people that come into the plot, but at this guy, we have a safe amount of plot. Perfect! Thank you! Already? Good, I'm glad my vassals like me. Like, this guy right here, this bishop really loves me. Like, if there's anything I can say to this guy, he's temperate, humble, kind. I mean, this guy and me, we are broskies, and we will never break each other up. My duke, though, kind of an annoying person. He, like... Well, there's absolutely nothing I can do in terms of, like, getting him in power. And I have to say thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys next time.